That might have been tricky. The answer should look something like this. There might be other ways to do it, but I think this is the simplest one. If you didn't get this, it's okay, there's more practice coming up. There are some subtleties to how this method works, so let's go through an example. Let's say we have two variables, one for Maria and one for Jamisha. Each of those should contain a person object with a name and friends. We have string objects for Maria's name, Maria's current friends, Jamisha's name, and Jamisha's current friends. Let's say we call Maria.addFriend Jamisha. We call this method on the Maria object, and we pass in as an argument the Jamisha object. Now when this line runs, the first thing that it does is creates a new string from these ones. This will be the new string that's created. It's going to put together friends, friend.name, and a space. Friends is the friends of the Maria object, because that's what we called the method on. So we go to the Maria object, and friends is currently just TJ with a space. Friend.name is the friend, the argument, which was the Jamisha object, .name, which is Jamisha, and the space is just a space. So when these strings get put together, it'll look like TJ space Jamisha space. Now the string created by this part will be assigned into the friends variable. So the old reference will go away, and a new one will be created. And now Jamisha appears in the friends of Maria. The old friends string that contained just TJ might still be around, and it hasn't changed, but the friends variable in the Maria object now contains a reference to a different string.